Simon & Schuster Audio presents Burned, a Regan Reilly Mystery by Carol Higgins Clark. Read by the author.
Thursday, January 13th. This is going to be the snowstorm of the century, the action reporter Brad Dayton cried with a certain hysterical glee. Clad in bright yellow foul weather gear, he was standing on the side of the New Jersey Turnpike. Cars were inching by, sliding and spinning as a gusty wind blew wet snow in every direction. The flakes seemed to target the reporter's face and the lens of the television camera. The sky was thick with gray clouds, and the whole Northeast was hunkering down for an unexpected blizzard. "Don't go anywhere," he cried as he blinked to avoid the pelting precipitation. "Stay home and forget the airports. They're closed and it looks like they won't reopen for several days." Regan Reilly stared at the television in her cozy Los Angeles office in an ancient building on Hollywood Boulevard. "I can't believe it," she said aloud. "I should have flown out yesterday." Regan looked out the window. It was a typically sunny day in Los Angeles. Her suitcase was packed for New York. Recently engaged, Regan was a 31-year-old private investigator based in Los Angeles. Her honey, Jack, no relation, Reilly, was the head of the major case squad in New York City. They were to wed in May, and she had been planning to fly out for the weekend to see Jack and her parents, Luke and Nora, who lived in Summit, New Jersey. Regan had been looking forward to a cozy weekend with Jack. It was the second week in January, and she hadn't seen him for 10 days. And what's more romantic than being together during a snowstorm? She felt lonely and frustrated by the sight of the shining sun. "I don't want to be here," she thought. "I want to be in New York." The phone rang. "Regan Reilly," she answered without much enthusiasm. "Aloha, Regan. It's your maid of honor calling from Hawaii." Regan smiled and immediately felt better just hearing her best friend's voice. Kit Callan and Regan had met in college on a junior year abroad program in England. Kit lived in Hartford and sold insurance. Her other job was to hunt for Mr. Wright. So far, she was having better luck peddling her policies. Regan knew that Kit had gone to Hawaii for an insurance convention. "Aloha, Kit. How's your trip going?" "I'm stuck here. My travel agent says you can't get anywhere near the East Coast." "Tell me about it. I was supposed to go to New York today to see Jack, and my mother and I were going to meet with the wedding planner." "Promise me you'll go easy on me with the bridesmaids' dresses."
"I was actually thinking of plaid pantsuits," Regan quipped.
"I've got an idea. Come out here to Waikiki and we'll pick up some grass skirts."
"What?" Regan said.
"This is a perfect opportunity for us to have a fun girls' weekend before your wedding. What else are you going to do for the next few days? Watch the weather reports? I have a room on the second floor with two big beds and a balcony overlooking the ocean. You can almost dip your toes into the sand from here. As a matter of fact, I'm sitting on the balcony right now waiting for room service to deliver my breakfast."
Regan looked around the office that had been her home away from home for several years. The antique desk she'd found at a flea market, the black and white tiled floor, the coffee pot in its place of honor atop a filing cabinet were all so familiar. But now, they didn't feel welcoming.
"Where are you staying?"
"The Waikiki Waters Playground and Resort."
"That's a mouthful."
"You should see this place. There are restaurants, shops, two spas, five pools, and there's a gala charity ball this Saturday night."
Kit paused.
"What's going on down there?" she said softly, more to herself than Regan.
"What are you talking about?" Regan asked.
Kit didn't seem to hear her. "I don't believe it," she said with alarm. Regan's grip tightened on the phone. "Kit, what's going on?" "People are suddenly running down to the water's edge. I think a body just washed ashore." "Oh my God, Kit." "Regan, you're not going to let me stay here by myself, are you?" Kit inquired meekly. "This place could be dangerous." "I'll call the airlines." Nora Regan Reilly looked up at the snow falling on the skylight of her third-floor tower office at home in New Jersey. Normally, a little snow would contribute to the cozy setting where she wrote her mystery novels, but the blizzard was causing havoc in her life and everyone else's in the tri-state area. "Regan, I'm so sorry you won't be in New York this weekend."
"Me too, Mom."
Regan was in the bedroom of her Hollywood Hills apartment, packing a suitcase with summer clothes.
"Your father has a big funeral scheduled for tomorrow. I don't know how it can possibly happen. They say the roads will be treacherous."
"Somehow the weather seems fitting for a funeral."
Regan's father, Luke, was a funeral director. And with her mother, Nora, being a suspense writer, there was a lot of talk about crime and death around the house. The Waltons, they were not. Regan was an only child, and as a result, she had been privy to more adult conversations than most kids growing up. It seemed to be common with only children, Regan had long ago decided. Jack was one of six kids. She loved that. Soon, they'd have the best of both worlds.
"Well, Regan, Hawaii doesn't sound so bad."
"It will be good to spend time with Kit."
"Have you told Jack your plans?"
"Of course. We're both disappointed that I'm not going to be in New York for the storm, but I'll be there next weekend."
"How long will you stay in Waikiki?"
"Just until Monday morning."
"Do you and Kit have any big plans out there?"
Regan dropped a red one-piece bathing suit into her suitcase. With her pale skin, she wasn't a sun worshiper, but she did enjoy taking a dip and then sitting under an umbrella. She had inherited her black Irish looks from her father. Raven-haired, blue-eyed, and fair-skinned, she was 5'7" tall. Luke was 6'5", and his hair was long since silver, as he liked to call it. Her mother was a petite blonde and had a more patrician look.
"We'll sit on the beach, maybe do some sightseeing. I think Kit has her eye on a guy who lives in Waikiki."
"Kit's probably happy she can't get home then."
"I think you're right, Mom. But as she said, a long-distance relationship takes on new meaning when you're talking about Connecticut to Hawaii."
Nora laughed. "I'm sure you two will have fun.
Be careful in the water. Those currents out there can get pretty strong."
"She has that Irish intuition," Regan marveled. Or was it her motherly radar? Regan was not going to mention that a body had washed ashore in front of Kit's hotel room, but her mother probably had a sense of something. Let Nora think she was going to have a relaxing weekend at a peaceful Hawaiian resort. Who knows? Maybe things would turn out that way after all.
"We'll be careful," Regan assured her mother.
She hung up, zipped up her suitcase, and glanced at the picture of her and Jack on the dresser. It had been taken moments after they got engaged in a hot air balloon. Regan couldn't believe how lucky she was to have found her soulmate. They'd met when her father had been kidnapped and Jack was on the case. Now Luke Reilly always joked that he never knew he had such good matchmaking skills. After all, Regan and Jack got to know each other while he was tied up on a boat with his chauffeur. But they were terrific together and had so much in common, especially their senses of humor. What they both did for a living also made them kindred spirits, and they often discussed their cases with each other. She had dubbed him Mr. Feedback. At the end of every conversation, he always told her he loved her and to be careful.
"I will, Jack," she said now to the picture.
I want to live to wear my wedding dress.
Brushing off the odd feeling of uneasiness that came over her, Regan pulled the suitcase off the bed and headed out the door.
Here I go on my bachelorette weekend, she thought. How bad can it be?
As Regan's plane made its descent into Honolulu, she peered out the window and smiled at the sight of the red neon letters.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.